Somewhere in this unassuming neighborhood, one can sit down for an excellent meal. But you won't find this place on Yelp, and unfortunately, I cannot tell you where it is exactly. Why not, you ask? It's not exactly a restaurant, you see, which means it's not, strictly speaking, legal.
What is this place? Pupusa house? I call it Pupusa house. I mean, like a pupusaria, I guess you could say.
It's a cultural thing. Traditionally, they serve out of their houses. Yeah. And it's just something that people bring over when they come. So this is about as traditional as it gets, right?
It's just like home.
Yep.
This is what's called a pupusa house. Literally, a house. This one's serving home-cooked Salvadoran meals. Once the living room, now the main dining area. The woman running it, we can't show her face, but she's been here for 10 years, serving a mostly Salvadoran clientele looking for a taste of home.
There's tamales.
First up, a staple done a little differently than the norm. Tamales wrapped in banana leaf and steamed.
Oh, that's delicious.
Next, the dish of the house, pupusas. Tortillas stuffed with ground pork or chicharrón.
You can get pupusas in Nicaragua, in Guatemala, but for some reason, Salvadorian pupusas get the most respect. General consensus seems to be they're the best.
I would agree.
George Azar is our Detroit fixer. He's been coming here with his friend Joe for years.
This is what makes it right here. Cool. It's this. Cortillo.
Cortillo, it's just a pickled slaw.
Salsa. And I'll do this, but I don't know if you're for after this one. What do you say?
I don't know if you can hang, man.
Is it a manly thing?
It's turning into it, seems like.
Mexican spicy. So Dorian, not spicy.
That's true, though. They don't like it. They don't do it that spicy. Wow. Chicharrón? Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a porky goodness in there.
Chicharrón.
Sure.
Chicharrón is fried pork. Fried pork and then ground with peppers, onion, and tomato. Simple.
Taking the liberty of ordering some indigenous Detroit beverages. That we've egregiously overlooked so far. Yeah. Now we need burners, which I haven't had.
It's like a cross between ginger beer and ginger ale. It's like not as spicy as ginger beer and not as sweet as ginger ale. It's like in the middle. It's my favorite beverage, honestly.
Yes, I needed this to enhance my street cred in Detroit so that I would be welcome back.
Then pollo asado and shrimp and garlic butter. That shrimp head on, thank you very much.
This is where it's at. God lives in there.
Butter, garlic, simple, delicious.
It's the low-fat butter. It's the garlic.
That's good. Yeah, that's good. It's like a big hug. How did you find your way here?
Honestly, it's only word of mouth.
Yeah, but wait, you have annoying foodie websites, right?
True. But they're not coming here.
They're not coming here.
Oh, no. If you're walking the door, you're like, oh.
There are thousands of foodies with ironic sunglasses and fedoras, and they're just waiting to get in here.
We don't want this place to come with the food. I get mad at him when he starts bringing different people in.
You'd hate a line of people outside waiting a 2-hour wait to get in here?
Yes.
I don't want to wait for my place. Who hates money?
With her, it's not about the money. It's about keeping the tradition alive.